Katsina Assembly to convert television viewing center to an Islamic school. The lawmaker says that the call became necessary because the schools were more important than the viewing centers. The Katsina State House of Assembly has begun the process of converting all television viewing centers across the 36 states, local government areas into Islamic school. The assembly commenced the process on Tuesday following a joint motion presented by a member representing Jubia constituency, Mustafa Yusuf Jubia, at the plenary presided over by the speaker, Tasiu Maigari. The lawmaker said that the call became necessary because the school were more important than the viewing centers. He explained that Islamic education had suffered many setbacks in most of the areas, especially the rural areas, hence the need for prompt action to address the setbacks. Mr. Yusuf Jibia added that if his prayers succeeded, the conversion would also assist in reducing the spate of insecurity in the state. He cited an instance during a dialogue with some bandits where they complained of lack of schools for their children, saying that the conversion would give them the opportunity to enroll them. If my prayers come true, it will also help in reducing the number of Al-Majiri children roaming the streets in the name of begging. Some of these viewing centers were abandoned and have become refuse dumps, criminal hideout, and a place where redundant youth hang around, Mr. Yusuf Jibia said. According to him, if the centers were converted, the government would recruit teachers to teach in the schools, hence providing employment for the people, not only the government, but also the wealthy individual and philanthropists in the areas can also employ them, he said. He added that the centers were established across the state primarily with the aim of enlightening the public on activities of the state government. Resolution. After deliberation by the lawmakers, the House ordered its joint committees on religious affairs and that of social development to study the appropriateness of the conversion. The House also ordered the committees of access to the number of those centers and also the non-functional Islamic across the state and report back within 3 months. Well. I think these people have started again. Why did they say they are going to convert the television viewing centers into Islamic school? Why not convert them into both Islamic and Christian school? These people have started again with their religion issue. Now they have started again with talking about viewing centers. Now they want to convert it into Islamic school. Why? Why Islamic school? Now they are saying they want to open that just because the bandits they met to negotiate with gave them the opinion or told them that they need. Oh goodness, what is this country turning into? Oh my God. Like seriously, bandits are the ones that are telling you what they want and what they need. And yet they're going on about destroying or going after innocent people who are only agitating for the secession. They went after Nnamdi Kanu. As if that's not enough, they went after Sunday Igbohu, and now they are talking about that they went to negotiate with bandits. The bandits were complaining that their children are not in school. That is why. Are these people for real? What does these people really take us for? They just go on about saying whatever garbage or rubbish that is in their mind. And they say, so they pampered even criminals. All the bandits are busy killing people, kidnapping innocent people, and they are pampering them. Instead, they are calling Nnamdi Kanu and Sunday Igbohu a terrorist. Just imagine what these people are doing. Is this not, they are just being biased. That's just it. These governments, they are really, really something else. Oh. Let's go into the comment section and hear what people have to say about this absurd word. Religion should be a personal issue. Taking state resource to fund a religious organization is criminal. Converting state source for personal use is corruption. Why not vocational training center where all unemployed youth can learn a skill, help themselves and the society? Oh, learning one's religion won't provide food on the table. By teaching one to depend on itself, not only him but these people here, they are really up to something. So they want to open Islamic schools, then teach them things about Islamics, right? And use that opportunity to brainwash them again and teach them how to take laws into their hands, how to kill innocent people, right? These people are really. How many Islamic schools are in the cities? Can't the government build Islamic schools if they want, okay? Must you convert people's viewing football center, okay, business to Islamic school? That is not even the problem. Because if they want to, they are talking about building Islamic school. How many Christian schools have the government built? Or how many viewing centers have they turned into a Christian school? All the whole Christian schools that are in this Nigeria belongs to an individual, belongs to one pastor or the other. So why can't a cleric, a sheikh or whatever, go and build an Islamic school for the Islamic people to go to the school? Why? Is an Islam, building an Islamic school the problem of the government? That is what I don't really understand. And yet the government will say nothing about it and give them even a listening ear to vomit this garbage out. Like, seriously? My own major concern are how they provide effective security for such learning centers so as not to eventually turn them into packs of bandits, raiding and kidnapping centers to fetch more ransoms for the pampered criminals. So Katsina State does not see a plot of land to build Islamic school. So they want to close all Katsina people's eyes. that cannot see what is happening in the state, okay? When Nnamdi Kanu opens his eyes, he ended up in prison. Okay? Just listen to what the son is saying. Whenever they are trying to advise the northerners to open their eyes and see what is happening, they will turn it around and turn it into a tribalistic discussion and want to counter what that person is saying and turn it into insults or sort of. Just imagine. It is for your own use or for your own good, rather. What is our business? If you like, turn the whole of north to Islamic school. That is none of our business. Negotiator. Building school for bandits, children, converting viewing centers to Islamic school. Other people are busy inventing things that will benefit humanity, and you are there closing bear palace, converting viewing centers. Sorry. This Abdul Alima, what was his name? Abubakar, okay? Mind your business. We haven't forgotten the way you steal small children in Kano, took them to your state and give them a new name and convert them to Christianity. We are still aware of your crimes. You are not qualified to speak about what is right about religion. Oh goodness, these people are indeed insane. I'm sorry to say, but I really think that these people really deserve what is happening to them in the north, because they don't really want people to tell them the truth. Whenever they are trying to make them understand what is going on, what is happening that they can't see, they turn it around and insult in the people that are trying to advise them. Just like what this Abdullahi is trying to say here. He's saying it is good in exposing the Bible. The likes of Ahmed Didat and Zaki Nek will be trained. When is your debater with these people are insane? And seriously, they really he gets people angry with all these their comments they are always making. Whenever someone is saying something reasonable, they comes out and say things that are off point, that someone will not even understand what they are saying. I want to say religious school is for business, teaching nothing. You put your children in religious school to learn nothing. Wonder Boko Haram criminal using religious against. These people are indeed really strange. That is why I keep on asking, how did these people come about to become Nigerians? How did they get into our country? That is the main question we are supposed to be asking ourselves. Like, seriously? Anyways, can go to the comment section and share your take on this article. Thanks for listening, and God bless you.